Welcome to the Hilltop International Christian Center. Here, miracles happen every day. Prayer is our lifestyle, where true worshipers gather to seek God, where dance of victory and the celebration of God's faithfulness, what joyous expressions. Here you will encounter God.
They peeped and saw my destiny.
The disciples made a comment. They said, "What manner of man is this? That even the storms obey him." There was a time he spoke to a man who was paralyzed, an invalid, paralyzed from his shoulders downwards. Brought in by his friends, he said, "Pick up your bed and go. Your sins are forgiven thee." The Pharisees said, "Can a man forgive sins?" He walked on water. There is nothing in the natural that could limit Jesus. So his disciples were trying to lay their hands on what was behind this unusual lifestyle. Now, before all of this came to pass, before Jesus came to this earth, the Bible says that God had concluded the entire project. For Jesus is the Lamb of God that was slain before the foundation of the world. When Jesus came 2,000 years ago, that was not when God was thinking about the plan. That was when the plan was being executed physically. But God had concluded the plan. When the Bible says he's the Lamb that was slain before the foundation of the world, even before the world was created, it means that in God's mind, this whole project had been concluded. And my excitement this morning is that if Jesus was slain and concluded his assignment even before the world started, then your own destiny has been concluded successfully even before your father met your mother. What you are going through now is not a surprise to God. God knows exactly what you are going through. Where you are now is not a surprise to God. God has seen this place before. He has concluded the journey and is just taking you through the journey. So God knows the curves, God knows the turns, God knows the potholes, God knows the valleys, and God knows the mountains. God knows every single thing you're going through. And if Jesus could not be stopped, you cannot be stopped.
My mother's womb, the beaten soul, my destiny. All I was meant to be, and all God had in store for me.
God was breaking out of the box. God was breaking out of the box because he wanted to live inside of you and live inside of me. And that presence that has been trapped in the box for years broke out of that box. And Jesus allowed the Holy Spirit to come and take his permanent residence within you and I. That's what John the Baptist said, and that's what he saw. He said, "The one that I'm introducing to you, he is greater than I. I'm baptizing you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire." Now, this is the message of the cross. This is the message of the redemption. Don't take your tent and pitch it by the cross and leave it there. No. You must travel through the grave. And when you get to the grave, you will find out that the grave is empty. The cross is empty. The grave is empty. That condition has no right to tie you down in the grave anymore. Jesus broke out of that grave, and the Holy Spirit broke out of the box. You need to get out of the box now. Amen? And you need to begin to do something significant for God. Because God now lives within you. You must not live your life now like you are an ordinary man. You must live your life like God is residing within you. You must talk like God talks. You must think like God thinks. You must walk like God walks. You must set your goals like God sets his goals. You must dream like God dreams. You must think big and expect big things. You must do great things for the kingdom of God. You must manifest and fulfill destiny in your generation. And what you do must be according to the size of God. Out of that box, stop restricting God and restricting yourself. So when Jesus said, pray thy kingdom come, so that thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. What he's saying is, this day is going to come when God himself will begin to live on your inside. And that presence of God on your inside is God himself giving you the ability to manifest heaven on earth. Because the Holy Spirit is the bridge between the heavens and the earth. You can now go out like Jesus. And you can do what Jesus did. Jesus told his disciples, he said, go now. Preach the gospel to every person. He said, cast out devils. Heal the sick. Raise the dead. Matthew chapter 10. I'm quoting Bible here. Matthew chapter 10 from verse 1 to 9. Raise the dead. And then he says, freely you have received, freely give. Freely received what? You have freely received the Holy Spirit. Now begin to release him freely. So the problem is not even receiving the Holy Spirit. The issue is, are we ready to freely share what we have received? That's the problem of the church. That's the challenge of the church. You have believers who think that all there is to your encounter with the Holy Spirit is speaking in tongues. So are you filled with the Holy Spirit? Yes. Ran-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. And that's all the proof they have that they are filled with the Holy Spirit. I found out from the scripture that the baptism of the Holy Spirit does not end with tongues. That is actually your introduction into the school of the supernatural. Speaking in tongues is a door. Now you get to a house and you stand by the door. Yes, I have arrived at the house. Enter inside. Is your bed by your door at home? Is your bed across your door? Is your dining table and all those things by your door? That money that you are hiding at home, are you hiding it by the door? It's not by the door. It's where? Inside. So when you speak in tongues, you are exploiting the spiritual capacity to enter. So in Acts chapter 2, you see they began by speaking in tongues. And as they lingered speaking in tongues, they began to see other manifestations. And in Acts chapter 4, the Bible says they came again and said, God, fill us. God filled them again. And this time it says, with great power gave the apostles testimony of the resurrection, and great grace was upon them all. They were exploiting the grace. Listen, saints, your company where you are working, if they don't feel the presence of the Holy Spirit, you are a failing Christian. You are carrying God about. There must be proof. Anywhere you stand, that is God's ambassador. Many of us are not, we don't even have enough nerves to tell people we are Christians. And in fact, if you are exploiting the grace you have received, a lot of times you may not even need to talk. The difference will just be clear. See, there's something different about this man. There's something different. As a pastor who was telling this story, that in their city, there's this spiritual shop. You know those shops they call spiritual shops? Where they sell sixth and seventh books of Moses, and Moses did not write sixth and seventh books. Moses wrote five books. That thing is a magical book that was put together by De Lawrence that is they are using to deceive people everywhere in the world. They will sell incense and some oils and different things. They will put picture of an Indian that has five hands on one side and five. You know what I'm talking about. God will help you if you have been patronizing them. Huh? So there was such a shop in their city. And then this man of God said, he decided, he doesn't need anything there. He decided that he's going to confront the darkness in that shop with the presence of God upon his life. So once a week, he will leave home and say, Lord, your word declares that the only thing permitted on earth here is your standard of heaven on earth. That's why Jesus came. And that's why he left the Holy Spirit on my inside. I'm going to that place right now, and I'm carrying the presence of God there. Heaven will invade that place. And then we'll leave home. Grasso, pento, kula, grande, esoko, brodogo, lovende. And then when he gets into the shop, he's praying just under his breath and just strolling through the aisles. Not talking to anybody, just strolling. They'll think, another customer has come. I hear you. After about 2 weeks, the owner of the shop called him. He said, I've noticed that each time you come here, there's something different about you. He had not spoken a word to the man. Not one word. But the man saw something. You see, if the glory is on you, it will be visible. The reason people are not following you to your God is because you have trapped God in the box. You are not releasing him. Or else they will come. They will come. When the glory, glory cannot be hidden. When it's visible, you don't need to introduce. People will see the glory and begin to follow. Now God is living on your inside. Let him loose and let him out. Thy kingdom come on earth. You go back to that street and say, in this street, Jesus will be Lord. Debam will not be Lord. In this street, in this community, Jesus will be Lord. The militants will not run havoc. When they come, everybody will be running all over, scatter. You can take charge of that as a new creation. Inside your house, I take authority and dominion. God, do back us. Lord, you said that heaven must touch the earth. I decree in the name of Jesus, let your kingdom come and let your will be done. Your presence in that neighborhood will change the character of the neighborhood. Every time they are breaking into people's houses, you can't stop it. See, they just broke into my neighbor's house. The next house might be my own. Ah, you are failing as a new creation. They have scared you. The devil has put you on the run. You are on your toes now. I think we should pack out of this place. Hey! They should pack out for you. Thy kingdom come! That's what the redemption came to bring to us, so we can reclaim God's lost territory.
The kingdom soul, my destiny. All I was meant to be, and all God had.
The city of Port Harcourt, when the church begins to shine, when we begin to release the one who lives on our inside, there should be no prostitutes in the streets. We should go and shine and bring them to Christ. No prostitutes in the street. All this rubbish going on in the political sectors, we can change it. Instead of going out there and patronizing corruption, we can change it. That's what Jesus came for. And that's why he's living on your inside. You see, the church will grow if we shine. when you take that IV card and pour the presence on it and give it to somebody, they will hear you. But if you don't even care as to share with someone, right? You are trapping God inside you. You trap him. You trap him. When God is expecting to bring the world back to himself, his kingdom come so that his will be done. And who will he use to do that? He will use his diplomats, his ambassadors on earth. So 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 19 says, we are ambassadors for Christ. Say, I am an ambassador. You are the embassy of heaven on earth. You are God's diplomat. He's living within you now, inside of you. So if they are going to write a letter to God, they should address it to you. God will get it. I want to reach God, no problem. Email him, chrisore@jesus.com. You'll get it. Amen? You are his ambassador. An ambassador does not depend on the resources of the company where he is domiciled or the country where he is domiciled. He depends on the resources of the country that sent him. The United States of ambassador is not paid. The United States ambassador in Nigeria is not paid in Naira. He is paid in U.S. dollars. His children attend American school, even here. His office is equipped with American equipment. If you go there, you will see U.S. military responsible for the security. He drives American vehicles. His gadgets are American. He is protected by the United States of America. And all his resources are catered for from the United States of America. So God said, you are my ambassador. You are my ambassador. So I will supply your needs according to my riches in glory by Christ, not according to the economic hardship in Nigeria. So the reason you are still struggling is because you are not carrying an ambassador's mentality. For as a man thinketh, so he is. You need to change to an ambassador's mentality. Now, many of us are wondering, why aren't my needs met? It's because you have been sacked long ago. The boss has fired you. Your name is no longer on the payroll. You are on your own now. So the salary is not coming because you are in contravention. He said, represent me. When you get there, you talk my talk. The ambassador of the United States to Nigeria does not say, my opinion is. No. When they ask him questions, he said, the opinion of my government. This is the position of my government. He doesn't speak for himself. You can't be out there saying, look, things are hard. Look, I'm just managing. Things are difficult. That's not diplomatic talk. That's not diplomatic talk. If you speak like that, you will be fired. The diplomat will say, the opinion of my government. And the last time I checked, the opinion of your government is that all your needs are supplied according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. That should be your talk. When you begin to talk kingdom talk, then his will in heaven will be done on earth in your life. So that's why many people are not having their needs met. They don't talk ambassadorial talk. Your kingdom said, by his stripes, you are healed. And you are saying, I'm so weak now. Hey, this thing will kill me. He said, look, withdraw him. Withdraw him from service. We can no longer work with him. He's not in agreement with the constitution of this country and diplomatic protocol. So they withdraw you. The person's body is here, but he has been repatriated to heaven. So he's just existing on earth. Huh? The document says, let the weak say, I am strong. The document says, himself took our infirmities and bare our sicknesses. The document says, they shall lay their hands on the sick and the sick will recover. You are saying, supposing I lay my hands and the person is not healed. Supposing you lay your hands and he's healed. At least give God a chance. I have noticed that the more people I pray for, the more healings I get. If I pray for 100 people, 10 of them get it, great. But if I pray for 10 people, it's very likely that maybe one or not even one may get healed. So you do more, you get more results. Huh? And then the more you do it, the more the grace increases and the more results you get. Let me close by saying, God lives within you now. And now that he's within you, let him loose. Talk like an ambassador. Think like an ambassador. Oh my goodness. There's no man that modeled that like the late Archbishop B.A. Idahosa. A man of God said, I have never seen a man that is so full of God like B.A. Idahosa. And I'm not suggesting he had no weaknesses. No man is infallible. But the man knew how to take advantage of the blood and how to walk by the Spirit. He told one chap who used to be, one man of God who used to be, we were students then. He used to be the second vice president of Christian Union then, when we were in the University of Benin. And later he became the president. Now he's a bishop in Church of God Mission. He told him then, as a young man, he just graduated. He said, you are going with me to Australia tomorrow. He said, Papa, I don't have a passport. He said, that's not what I said. I said, you are going with me to Australia tomorrow. He said, yes, but sir, I don't have an international passport. He said, that is not what I said. You are going with me to Australia tomorrow. He said, yes, sir. Good. So tomorrow come, we'll go to Australia. And they went to Australia and came back. And he still didn't have a passport. How did it happen? I don't know. But that's a man who is full of God. Can you imagine somebody, not even visa, passport. The passport they will put the visa, he didn't have it. Just by associating with a man who is full of God. Huh? I met an archbishop in Tampa, Florida, many years ago, 1999. I was preaching for him in his church in Tampa, Florida. And he shared an account with me. He said, he was ordained as an archbishop by Archbishop B.A. Idahosa. He said the archbishop told him once, they were entering an elevator. The elevator had been called to another floor by somebody else. So they saw the arrow of the elevator pointing up. And they were going down. So the archbishop said, step in, let's go down. He said, no, Papa, this lift is going up. He said, I said, enter. And he got in, he punched the number. He said, go down. The lifts are going down. He said, this is what the man of God did. He said, I was amazed. He said, even elevator, is that not what Jesus did? When you are possessed with that consciousness, natural forces bow to you. A lift that was called up changed his mind. Changed his mind and started going down. He said, and that day, Archbishop told me, he said, Bolden, that's his name. Sorry, I've leaked the name now. He said, I want you to meet me in Caracas, Venezuela, where I'm preaching a crusade. He said, he told him, he said, sir, at this time, I'm believing for finances and He said, he looked him in his face. He said, faith is not damageable. Meet me in Caracas tomorrow. What that means, I'm still exploring it. He said, he stared me in my face and called me by my name. He said, faith is not damageable. Meet me in Caracas tomorrow. He said, yes, sir. That's it. 2 hours later, someone called him and said, I have been troubled since the past 2 hours to buy you a first-class ticket to Caracas, Venezuela. Are you going to Venezuela? When a man that knows who he is and what he's carrying speaks, heaven attends. That was diplomatic protocol. When the diplomat calls on the nation for attention, they respond. That was an ambassador speaking. He said, meet me in Caracas tomorrow. And someone bought him a first-class ticket whom heaven had mandated. Listen, saints. Your days in this realm of failure is over. Your days in the realm of defeat is over. Your days in the realm of poverty is over. Your days in the realm of fear is over. Your days in the realm of weakness is over. I speak from this diplomatic position, this ambassadorial office, I decree and I declare, whatever it is that you need now, receive it in the name of Jesus. I said, receive it in the name of Jesus. Amen. You need healing in your body, receive it.
Amen.
You need breakthrough in your finances, receive it.
Amen.
You need courage and boldness, receive it.
Amen.
Whatever you need to move you to the next level, receive it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Amen. John the Baptist said, he will baptize you with the Holy Ghost. I declare, receive that baptism. You were filled with the Holy Spirit. You are speaking in tongues. Receive a fresh baptism of fire.
Amen.
Receive it now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Receive it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
The beaten soul, my destiny. All I was meant to be and all God had in store for me.
To order for this message, please request for the message number above. You can also request for other messages by Reverend Chris Oare when you call 084-779-290, 0803-182-6714, 0803-182-6712, or 0803-182-6702. For more details about Reverend Chris Oare, the Hilltop International Christian Center, and other products and programs, please visit our website, www.hilltopinternational.org.